Hello everybody, today we are going to see some problems which are depend on the concept volume of sphere. Okay, so first problem is find the surface area of football cover made of 12 regular pentagons and 20 regular hexagons, each side 6 cm. Okay, and here it is given area of pentagon of 6 cm side is 61.92 cm square. Okay, and here figure is given area of pentagon. Pentagon means this is 5-sided figure, closed figure, and hexagon means 6-sided closed figure. Okay, side of both pentagon and hexagon is same, 6 cm. Okay, so now what we have to do here, see carefully, find the surface area of football made of 12 regular pentagons and 20 regular hexagon. Regular means what? All sides, equiangular and equiside. Okay, so here sides are given, understood? So now total area of football cover, which is made up of 12 regular pentagon and 20 regular hexagon. So we need to find out curved surface area of 12 regular pentagon and curved surface area of 20 regular hexagons. So when we will do the sum of both the areas, curved surface areas, that time we will get total surface area or area of football cover we can find out. Okay, so here first thing is given area of a pentagon is equals to what is given, 61.92 centimeter square. This is a area of a pentagon, curved surface area of a pentagon, understood? Like that, how many are there? See, 12 regular pentagons are there. Okay, so area of 12 regular pentagons is equals to 12 multiplied by 61.92 centimeter square. 12 multiplied by 61.92 centimeter square. So here we will get 12 2s are 24, 12 9s are 108, 743.04. 743.04 means this is the area of 12 regular pentagons. Okay, so here we got. Now we will think about hexagon. Okay, hexagon means 6-sided closed figure. Okay, figure is also given and side is 6 cm. Okay, one more thing we must know about a regular pentagon, that is this hexagon we can convert into six equilateral triangles. Okay, it can be converted into 6 equilateral triangles. So directly we cannot find out curved surface area, understood? So first we will find out area of a equilateral triangle. Okay, then we will multiply by 6, because this can be converted into 6 regular 6 equilateral triangles. So we are going to find out that this is first thing which we got. Finally we will use this. Okay, 743.04. so now side of hexagon, what is given? Side of hexagon is equals to 6 cm. Side of hexagon is given 6 cm, understood? Now area of equilateral triangle is equal to area of equilateral triangle. Which formula we use? Equilateral triangle is equals to root 3 by 4 into side square. Root 3 by 4 into side square. Okay, so what is root 3? 1.73. what is the value of root 3? 1.73 multiply by what is side? 6 cm, 6 square divided by 4. Okay, so this product we will do here. So 1.73 multiply by 6 square is 36 divided by 4. Okay, so 1.73 into 36, it will be 62.28 divided by 4. So here it will come 4 ones are 4, 2 remain 22, 4 5s are 20, remain again 2, 22, 4 5s are 20, remain 2 and 28, 4 7s are 28. So 50.57 centimeter square. Okay, this is the area of a equilateral triangle. This is area of equilateral triangle, a equilateral triangle, understood? So how many equilateral triangles you will get from a hexagon? 6 equilateral triangles. So here we need to multiply by 6. Okay, so you will get area of a hexagon. Okay, so area of a hexagon is equals to 6 multiply by is equals to 6 multiply by 15.57 centimeter square. 6 multiply by 15.57 centimeter square. So it will be 98.42 centimeter square. Understood? 98.42 centimeter square. Okay. So now here, 93.42 centimeter square. This area 6 7s are 42 2 4 carry 6 5s are 30 30 plus 4 34 4 3 carry 15 6 are 90 plus 3 93.42 centimeter square. So this is the area of a hexagon. Like that, how many hexagons are there? 20 regular hexagons are there. Understood? So we need to multiply by 20. So area of 20 regular hexagon is equals to 20 multiply by 93.42 centimeter square. So this product will be, we will multiply by 2 2s are 4 4 0 4 2s are 8 okay 3 2s are 6 and 9 2s are 18. Okay, after two digits, so it will come here. So 1868.40 centimeter square. So this is the area of 20 regular hexagons. Understood? Now we have to do the sum. Area of football. Football is made up of 12 pentagons, regular pentagons, and 20 regular hexagons. Okay, so area of football is equals to what we will do, this addition 743.04, this is area of 12 regular pentagons. So that I am taking here 743.04 plus this area of 20 regular hexagons. So that is 1868.40 centimeter square. So that is, addition is 2611.44 centimeter square. Okay, so what is the question? Area of football cover is 2611.44 centimeter square. Okay, so see here what we have done. This is, you can find out, because here it was given, area of a regular pentagon was given. We have to multiply by 12 because 12 regular pentagons are there, and that product is 743.04. that is very simple thing. Only we need to think about hexagons. We can convert from hexagon, you will get 6 equilateral triangles. So we have to find out area of equilateral triangle with the help of √3/4. This we have seen, √3/4 into side square. So 1.73, value of √3, 1.73 multiply by 6 square is 36 divided by 4. So that product 62.28 divided by 4, and this is final answer. Okay, this is area of one equilateral triangle. There we can convert into 6 equilateral triangles. Means in a hexagon there are 6 equilateral triangles. So we have multiplied this by 6. So we got 93.42 centimeter square. Okay, and like that 20 regular hexagons are there. So again we have multiplied by 20. So that answer we got, this 1868.40 centimeter square. And finally we have to do the areas of pentagon, 12 pentagons and 20 regular hexagons. So that is 2611.44 centimeter square. Okay. Okay, our second problem is, a spherical ball of diameter 21 centimeter is melted and recasted into cubes, each of side 1 centimeter. Find the number of cubes thus formed. Okay, this is a simple question. See here what is given, spherical ball of diameter 21 centimeter. Diameter is given 21 centimeter. Is melted means here we need to find out volume of sphere. okay, of diameter, whose diameter is 21 centimeter, is melted and recasted into cubes, each of side 1 centimeter. Okay, now find the number of cubes thus formed. So here first we need to find out volume of sphere, and secondly we will find out volume of cube. Okay, and then we need to divide. Okay, the volume of cube, volume of sphere divided by volume of cube, then you will get number of cubes thus formed. Understood? So here first we will find out volume of sphere. Okay, volume of sphere is equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube. Okay, which formula we use? 4 by 3 pi r cube. Here radius is given, diameter is given, and we have to find out radius. So first we will take here diameter is 21 centimeter. So radius will be 21 by 2 centimeters. 21 by 2 centimeters. Understood? So now here 4 by 3 into 22 by 7 multiply by r. What is radius? 21 by 2. So 21 upon 2. It's cube, so 21 by 2 we will multiply 3 times, 21 by 2 centimeter cube. Okay, so this will give you volume of sphere. Okay, so here we can solve this. 2 are 4, here 7 3s are 21, 3 will be cancelled. Okay, again this 2 will be cancelled. Here 2 into this 11, okay, 11 2s are 22. So what is remaining finally? 21 into 21, 11 multiply by 21 into 21. Okay, so this product is 4851 centimeter cube. This is the volume of a sphere. Okay, then what happens here? And recasted, melted and recasted into cubes, each of side 1 centimeter. Understood? So we can find out very easily volume of cube. So volume of cube is equal to what? Side cube, or L cube also we can write. So what is that? L cube is, side is 1 centimeter. So 1 centimeter into 1 centimeter into 1 centimeter. So that will give you 1 centimeter cube. Okay, now very simple. This is the volume of sphere divided by volume of a cube. Then you will get number of cubes. So number of cubes is equals to 4851 centimeter cube divided by 1 centimeter cube. So it will be cancelled. So final answer is 4851 cubes. Okay. Okay, so here our next problem is, the diameter of a copper sphere is 6 centimeter. The sphere is melted and is drawn into a long wire of uniform circular cross section. If the length of the wire is 36 centimeter, find its radius. Okay, this is question. Now what is given? See, the diameter of a copper sphere is 6 centimeter. So radius you will get easily here, 3 centimeter. The sphere is melted. Sphere is melted and is drawn into a long wire of uniform circular cross section. Uniform circular cross section. Understood? So now if the length of the wire is 36 centimeter, find its radius. We have to find out radius of the wire. Understood? So first what we will do, we will find out volume of copper sphere. So radius that is r of copper sphere is equals to 3 centimeter, 6 by 2, 3 centimeter. Understood? So volume of copper sphere is equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube. 4 by 3 pi r cube. Understood? So that is 4 upon 3 into pi multiply by radius. Radius is 3 into 3 centimeter cube. Understood? These 3 will be cancelled. 3 are 9, 9 4s are 36 pi centimeter cube. That is the volume of sphere, copper sphere. Understood? Now what we will do, it is drawn into a long wire. Long wire means it is in cylindrical shape. So here we need to use volume of cylinder. Okay, so that is pi r square h. Okay, cylindrical wire, volume of cylindrical wire or cylindrical in shape. Okay, so volume of cylindrical wire, that is pi r square h. Volume of cylinder formula we will use, pi r square h. Pi we are going to keep as it is. Radius we are going to find out, that is the question. And height is given, height they have told us 36 centimeters. So pi into r square into 36. So 36 pi r square. Okay, so this is the volume of a cylindrical wire. Definitely this whole material is used to make wire, understood? So definitely volume of both are same. So directly we can compare them. 36 pi is equal to 36 pi r square. Okay, so this 36 pi and this side 36 pi will be cancelled. So what is remaining here? R square is equal to 1. So radius is equal to 1 centimeter. Radius is equal to 1 centimeter. Understood? So that is our answer. R is equal to 1 centimeter. Got it, everybody? What we have done? First find out volume of copper. Okay, with the help of radius is given 36 pi centimeter square. Finally, this volume of cylinder, put the values, you will get same. Don't put here value of pi, otherwise the calculations will be again we need to multiply by 22/7. Instead of that, anyhow pi is going to be cancelled, so keep as it is. And finally we will get radius 1 centimeter. Okay.